If something was going to change, that Parkland was a tipping point, show of hands. Why did you feel this time was different?
This time, because the kids, the children from the school, have been so front and center and so active that it just gave a little bit of a different feeling, especially because they're the next generation and they're speaking up. Not that I agree with what they're pushing, but I think the use of social media and the snowball effect from what they've been able to do in this past week is entirely different from any of the previous incidents.
People have had enough. It's really that simple. I think sentiment is changing. I said the first day that there was going to be a tipping point at this point. We've just had enough of this constant carnage. And the question becomes, why do we not do something about it? It's really that simple. Why?
I think that we're having a really hard time focusing in on what the real issues are. And we all want this to stop, and we all want a fix, you know? But the fix isn't banning guns. The fix is much deeper than that.
Well, let's just take a vote right here. How many people would be comfortable with an assault weapons ban? Show of hands. Two of you. Okay, why not?
I don't think there needs to be a ban. There needs to be modifications to the weapons, limitations to the weapons.
Meaning not high magazine Correct. Capacity?
Correct. An AR-15 should not be used as a home protection weapon.
Why not? Welcome to 1984.
Do you know what a fabulous gun that is for women?
It is a fabulous gun. So is a shotgun.
Yeah, a shotgun's actually a much better weapon.
No, but it's much harder to handle. Not for a woman.
Your accuracy doesn't have to be.
Gary has a great
point.
That's a fallacy, too.
If you hear a pump-action shotgun go, most people will leave.
That's a fallacy.
You also don't need home protection. You don't need guns for home protection. The probability that you'll be involved in a gun-related crime is 0.003%.
If I have somebody breaking into my home, I need a means of self-defense. Whether that's a handgun, whether that's an AR-15, that should be my choice. And frankly, I think the law allows that choice.
If they banned AR-15s, you could still defend yourself with your handgun.
Possibly.
And a shotgun.
You guys are missing the key point here. This is a Second Amendment right.
We're not taking away your guns.
Let me finish, please. This is a constitutionally protected right. This is not a government legislated privilege, such as driving a car. This is a completely different conversation.
Yep, fair enough. But do you think the forefathers meant the AR-15?
I think they meant our protection against a tyrannical gun of government and for our self-protection.
So do you believe
of course they don't know what the guns are, but if you can't start messing with our constitutionally protected rights
there are interpretations, obviously, of what the forefathers meant. I mean, you're not actually allowed to have an automatic weapon.
I know why you want them. I know they make a lot of noise. They shoot a lot of bullets. Very macho gun. It's cool looking. I understand why they want them. But nobody can tell me why you need it.
We don't have to need it. It's a constitutionally protected right.
Those kids need it to live.
Yeah. Of course they did.
And the AR-15 isn't a constitutionally protected right.
It's no different from any other.
You have the right to self-defense, and it's not only a Second Amendment right. You have the right to life, liberty, pursuit of happiness, and that is all about protecting yourself, protecting your family.
Right. And all those kids have the right to life, and they're dead.
You cannot yell fire in a movie theater, even though we have the right to free speech. Mm-hmm. And we've already decided that you cannot have an automatic weapon. All right, so all we're talking about is where the line is.
But the line is for military use, and an AR-15 is not a military rifle. It is a regular semi-automatic rifle that looks badass.
What about a semi-automatic?
If you didn't own an assault rifle, an AR-15, would your lifestyle change any?
My lifestyle?
Because there's other firearms I would purchase.
But my concern for my country and in the protection of our Second Amendment rights would.
So
that's scary.
At what point will we have to stand up against our government and use lethal force in the year 2000?
It's happening in Venezuela.
There's a million slippery slope arguments that we can use, but let's try to stay in the present. So here's what's being proposed today, okay? Do you support the end of the sales of bump stocks, making bump stocks illegal?
Absolutely.
Show of hands. Three of you. Why would you not support an end to bump stocks that mowed down 58 people from a window?
Well, that's a loaded question.
A gun cannot do anything unless someone is operating it.
Thank you.
It is a tool. And if sick people have a mental issue, that is them. It's not the gun.
I could do the same thing with my
By law, it's not illegal.
It's an accessory.
It's not considered an automatic weapon. Oh. I have a bump stock.
And do you know
how many times has a bump stock been used in a mass shooting?
But why are you comfortable with that? Why are you defending bump stocks?
Because I think it should be available. I think it should be available to those out there. Because it's not an issue of the gun itself or the weapon itself.
Right.
It's an issue of the individual behind it.
And which individual would want to use a bump stock?
A crazed individual, right?
Why
not ban
them?
Who was going to a mass shooting?
Why not ban them?
What does that accomplish, though? What are we going with?
It keeps those 58 people alive.
Once you start doing that, what's the next accessory?
Right.
Now you're opening up a whole other thing because it's not a firearm.
Let's keep going through what the solutions are. President Trump is proposing arming teachers, those that are trained and adept. Who's comfortable? Arms up.
If they want to, as a volunteer.
If they want to, voluntarily.
Voluntarily.
Voluntarily. Why aren't you comfortable with that, Amanda?
I mean, I'd feel like this shouldn't even need to be explained. I think Mr. Trump is way off the mark on this. You don't want to bring more guns into a situation. The answer to solving violence is not more violence.
You were a teacher
for 7 years.
Yeah,
the last thing I want is a gun in my classroom. And when you're trying to shoot a shooter that's in the building, you're going to hit kids. Or if the police show up and you're a black teacher holding a gun because you were defending against a shooter, you're going to get shot.
I totally understand what you're saying and that concern, and I know a lot of people have that, you know, but I think we agree we don't want people armed that aren't prepared to do what needs to be done if they have to and don't have the training.
No one can possibly be prepared for a situation where you're firing gunshots around children.
You don't have that right to make that choice for children that are in school when they could be protected by somebody potentially with a gun
that
has training. You don't have the right to rule over their life and say that they didn't have the opportunity to save those children.
But you're ruling over their lives saying that we should have AR-15 and allow someone to bring it in.
Incorrect.
For my self-protection or in a classroom, I want anything that's better than what he has. And I want more rounds than whatever he has.
Okay, so here's...